What's up, ladies and gentlemen? Daily here from Frag Nation and Nation Fusion, and today I have a review for you for the Nuka-Cola World, or Nuka World, DLC for Fallout 4. The Nuka World DLC for Fallout 4 is the last DLC for Fallout, and is by far one of the most interesting pieces of DLC content that I've seen in quite some time, because of its ramifications and story endings and things of that nature. You really have a lot of choices here, and there's a lot of gameplay. So let's first start off talking about what it is as a whole. So you start out in your regular Commonwealth, and you get a radio beacon that you can listen to. Upon listening to it, you hear that Nuka World is open, and it gives you a waypoint at the edge of your map that you can use to travel to Nuka World. Once you get there, there's some gunners or some bad guys there that are looking to go over to Nuka World as well. You take those guys out, and you proceed to head into Nuka World. Once you get there, you are then run through what's called the Gauntlet, which is a pretty cool trap-inspired thing from Fallout. You may have seen something similar to it in one of the abandoned parking garages earlier in the campaign, if you have stumbled across that or not. It's basically just a bunch of death traps and a bunch of challenges leading up with you having to face off against the quote-unquote overboss of all of the gangs that are running Nuka World, which is run by three rival raider gangs. So one of my first issues here was just the way in which the story kind of unfolds. After, and this is a spoiler alert here, after you get through the initial fight of the boss, you are given control over all three gangs immediately just because you killed the overboss in a cheap way. Not going to spoil that. In any case, it just seems like all of the short guesswork has been cut out, and then now all of a sudden you're in charge of the gangs. I didn't like that. I felt like none of these gangs, at least the gangs in the world that Fallout has built, would ever allow somebody who just is an outsider to come in and lead them like you do in this particular thing. So the storytelling is a little bit lax there. It's just a little too whimsical. And you just kind of have things handed to you right off the bat. After that, though, the gameplay does open up pretty cool. I would have liked maybe a couple of quests before getting in here to win the favor or win the trust of all three gangs. Now, once you are the overboss, you're now set to control Nuka World, who has basically a several sections, themed sections, since this is a theme park, that are infested with ghouls and things called bloodworms, a new enemy type, as well as some mutant animals that you'll just have to find out for yourself in the game. So right there off the bat, you're getting new enemies to fight. You're getting new gangs to learn, and each of the gangs have armor, so you're getting new armor sets. There is a new weapon as well, an AK-style assault rifle. So it's good to have that in the game. Finally, a lot of people say, hey, you know, where's the AK? It was invented in the Fallout timeline. It should be here. It's one of the most popular weapons in the world. And now you do have access to those. And there's some cool customization parts on there as well. So weapons, check. Gear, check. Quests, check. Story, I don't know. This is where it gets kind of fuzzy again, because once you complete all of the main quest lines for Nuka World, you're then given the option to expand your gang's rule to the Commonwealth. And that just fucks everything up in the sense of the story. But if that's not a problem for you, if you don't mind being a raider or you want to be a raider, you don't have to be. There is an option that that kills all of the gangs off. You can just go in there and murder them all. But realistically, the way that they have planned this DLC out with the different perks and all of the quest lines that follow, it seems like the thing that they want you to do is to be a overboss of these raider gangs. Now, you can do things peacefully, you can do things non-peacefully, so you do have different options there, and I do appreciate that. It just seems kind of, as I said earlier, just doesn't really fit what the story we've been getting from Fallout up until this point. So what else? I didn't really like all of the different fetch quests that are in this one. There's a ton of scavenger-like quests, and they are extremely hard. Like, I would have still been doing them if I didn't use the toggle god mode, and I wasn't using a guide to help me kind of get through this so I can experience all the stuff to kind of relay it to you guys. There is a ton of fetch quests where you have to go to each individual park and look for different clues on the sides of walls and things like that without really much of a hint. You have like this little piece of paper flyer that gives you a couple of hints, but there's no map markers for that. Then there's a collection quest where you have to go to all of the different rides and all the different worlds, parks, I guess, here in Nuka World and collect a token. There's quests for all of the different, what do you call those things? The bosses, the leaders of their gangs have their own respective quests. So there's a lot there, and just I feel like some of them are just really tedious, such as the searching for the medallions and the caps and clearing out all the buildings. There was a lot there. And then one of the other weird things is you cannot turn the power on to the park until after you've completed all the main questline DLC without... I'm not going to spoil it, but it just doesn't make sense that the way the quests are laid out with the power plant and things of that nature. So, I mean, besides a little bit of sloppy storytelling and a little bit of sloppiness on the quests, there is a lot of content here. It will take you a long time to complete all of the DLC here and to complete all of the missions that are set in this fairly large. It's definitely not as big as Far Harbor, but it's a fairly large map, and there's quite a bit to do there. So, overall, is Nuka World worth the price? If you have the season pass, this is again a yes. Definitely worth the season pass to get all these DLCs together. The issue that I have is the price point structure for the individual pieces of content. That's not necessarily to my liking, but as a whole, if you're going to pick up one, you just pick up the season pass and you're good to go. So with that said, I think we are going to have to score the Nuka World DLC a solid 8 out of 10. Just the quests being so just scattered and fetchy, that's going to have to dock a point. And then the kind of messed up, unorganized story is going to have to dock another point. But overall, a solid DLC and something I did enjoy playing. Thank you guys so much for watching. I hope you enjoyed this video. Let me know in the comments down below what you think of the Fallout Nuka World DLC. Is it to your liking? Is it something you want to pick up? Do you have more questions? I don't know. Let me know in the comments, and I'd be happy to talk with you. Thank you guys so much for watching, and we'll see you next time on Nation Fusion TV.